I'd like to welcome you back today for another one in our series of Candida myth videos. Today's Candida myth is oxygen kills Candida. The best way to dispel this myth is just to look at the basic physiology of the human intestinal tract. The small intestine is approximately 20 feet in length, and the large intestine is approximately 5 feet in length. Within this 25-foot tube exists 100 trillion bacterial cells. These 100 trillion cells outnumber human cells by a factor of 10 to 1. Within these 100 trillion cells, we know that 95 to 99% of them are anaerobic bacteria. Anaerobic bacteria live in an oxygen-deprived environment, and it takes an oxygen-deprived environment to create the ecosystem of the digestive tract. Aerobic bacteria, which are commonly found in the environment, live in an oxygen-rich environment. The air around you is an example of an oxygen-rich environment. The air in outer space would be an example of an oxygen-deprived environment. When discussing bacteria, we want to understand that there are bacteria that are either obligate aerobes or anaerobes, or they are facultative aerobes or anaerobes. Obligate aerobes are obligated to live in an oxygen-rich environment. Facultative aerobes can live either in an oxygen-rich or an oxygen-deprived environment. Now, this is true also for obligate anaerobes. Obligate anaerobes are obligated to live in an oxygen-deprived environment, whereas facultative anaerobes can live in either an oxygen-rich or an oxygen-deprived environment. So when we're discussing Candida, it's important to note that Candida is classified as a facultative anaerobe. That means it can live in an oxygen-deprived environment, such as the intestinal tract and much of the human tissues of the body, or it can live in an oxygen-rich environment, such as the surface of your skin or tongue. An example of an aerobic fungal Candida infection would be thrush or some type of fungal skin condition. Most of the initial research that was done with Candida involved Candida in an aerobic state. So most people are aware of thrush or fungal skin infections. And ask anybody who has a thrush infection, this is a very difficult infection to get rid of. And many times fungal Candida skin infections are the same way. It wasn't until later years that they started to actually investigate Candida as a facultative anaerobe, and looking into anaerobic environments such as the intestinal tract. So from the basic physiology, we can see that Candida as a facultative anaerobe can live either in an oxygen-rich environment or an oxygen-deprived environment. This alone dispels the myth that oxygen kills Candida. If we take it further, we find that Candida is very adaptive and almost instantaneously adaptive in its anaerobic environment in the digestive tract. Some of our earlier videos demonstrate the effects of white blood cells in trying to destroy Candida. When a white blood cell consumes, a white blood cell such as a macrophage or a neutrophil consumes a bacteria, and we have videos that are on our site that demonstrate this, you'll see that within a few seconds, the bacteria dissolves inside the white blood cell. However, when these same white blood cells consume Candida, the Candida survives. So it's important to look at what's happening in a white blood cell. When a substance is consumed by a white blood cell, the white blood cell forms a little sac around the bacteria or the Candida. And then inside the white blood cell, there will be another sac that is filled with oxygen. These two sacs will meet, the oxygen will be released into the sac containing the microorganism, and it will cause dissolution or dissolving of that organism spontaneously. But when you see the videos of Candida being consumed by white blood cells, you see the Candida inside the white blood cells accumulate more and more because the oxygen has no effect against the Candida. Another place to look at is back to the research. Candida contains a molecule called a quorum sensing molecule called farnesol. Farnesol enables Candida to survive high levels of oxygen if it's ever exposed to that within the digestive tract. A quorum sensing molecule like farnesol plays a role in determining whether Candida becomes a yeast form or a fungal form. And that's what quorum sensing molecules do. They have an effect on the genetics and how the genetics function with inside the cells. So based on our understanding of the physiology, based on what we know about Candida as a facultative anaerobe, and based on what research studies continue to show us, it's easy to see that Candida is not affected by oxygen, and in fact, seems to grow even hardier in an oxygen-rich environment.